colder than a Philly fan's heart, eh? Me in town without my vacuna coat.
No smoking. Huh? Oh. All right, where are we going?
Ninth and Catherine.
Hey, turn that up.
No,
the Mozart. You like classical music?
Hmm. Yeah, relaxes me.
Relax, you buy a jacuzzi. This is serious. The 41st, that's the culmination of Mozart's career.
Not the Requiem?
No, the Requiem he'd given up. At the 41st, there's still a lot of life. But he knows he's nearing the end. Hey, basic Mozart lecture, okay? Hear the melody?
Nice. Huh?
Nice as the Beach Boys. Listen. There. You hear that? You hear that beneath the nice melody? The counterpoint, huh? Hear that counterpoint? The dark underside.
Mozart ain't simple.
Yeah. No, and Einstein ain't dumb. My father always said I had all the answers. None of the solutions. If only we could turn back the clock, huh?
Erase the mistakes.
Yeah. Mistakes I can live with, but it's the mistakes after the mistakes.
Where are you from?
Oz. There was a man in the land of Oz. Oh.
Almost there.
Huh?
Any place in particular?
Palumbo's?
Been closed for years.
Well, okay, I'm sorry. What's the other place?
Ralph's Italian.
Let's go over to Franklin Field.
Uh-huh. And we get there, then what? You got any money?
Forgive me.
Sorry, I gotta drop you.
Forgive yourself.
You all right, buddy? Huh? It's okay. It's okay. It's all right. You stay the cab.
I'm so afraid to go. Say a prayer for me, will you, buddy?
Where do you want to go?
Home.
Just tell me where you want to go.
Home. I want to go home.
Thank you. He's a DOA. You don't need a detailed statement.
Oh, that's my call, sir. What's your name?
Michael Olshansky.
And she used to be on the job?
Next question.
All right,
the Riverbanks. An hour ago.
And then what happened?
I drove and we shot the breeze.
About what?
Does that matter? Officer Nelson? The guy died. Write it down. Dead. Could be important.
Just trying to do a job here.
Yeah, I'd like to get back to mine.
Are you the cab driver who brought him in?
Yeah.
Dr. Weiss.
Hey.
Did he happen to introduce himself to you?
No.
Okay. Thanks for your help. Officer Nelson.
Whoa. You're saying the man's a John Doe?
Well, no wallet, no ID, nothing.
Well, there must be something in his pocket.
I'll handle it from here.
Yeah. Right.
Occupational hazard? Bloodshot eyes.
When you pull a double, yeah. I lost some road time last night. Guy died in my cab.
No lie.
Right where you were sitting.
Wow. My luck, I won't die until after this weekend. Thanksgiving with the whole family, you know the drill. Cousins whose names you never remember, old aunts and uncles, everybody dwelling on the past. Sounds great, huh?
Does to me. Where to?
You know. Home? You'll take me there?
I don't know where it is.
You'll find it.
Why me?
You're suffering. But do you know why? Don't make my mistake.
What mistake?
Have you said that prayer for me?
What was the mistake? Tell me. What was your mistake?
Come on, let's move it up.
You have to wonder what happens to a guy like that. What mistakes he made.
Digging into a homeless man's past. Why do you even want to go down that road?
Maybe it's yellow brick.
Huh?
Yellow brick road. It's a joke. Wizard of Oz.
What about it?
Well, when I asked where the guy's from, he says there was a man in the land of Oz.
Oz.
What?
Not Oz. Oz. In the land of Oz, there was a man who was blameless and upright. First verse in the book of Job. Your man was suffering.
Job got screwed over by God.
No, God tested Job. He trusted that Job would never lose his faith, and he was right.
Of course he was. He's God. This guy, he just wanted me to drive him home.
He is home. No, let him go. Let him go. Move on. Take care of your own.
He isn't home. He told me.
So you do this for you or for him?
For him.
I don't think so. What does he get? What does his family get you delivering a dead man?
Well, maybe I deliver his soul. You ought to understand that.
If he truly believed, his soul has already been delivered.
I can't have this discussion with you. You got too much home field advantage.
I know that Dr. Weiss found a key in that man's pocket.
A key to what?
First National Bank.
Could have been a label on it, Ronnie.
I don't know, Mike. Is it okay for me to be talking to you?
There's no law against it, Ronnie.
Oh, okay. There was a photograph in his pocket.
Photograph of what?
I didn't see it, but I heard the policeman say that it wasn't of any use to him.
Why?
Didn't have no faces.
Oh. Can you think of anything else?
The dead man, he had a little Bible, and that's all I can think of.
Well, you did good, Ronnie. Thanks.
You don't find this man's family, the city's gonna cremate him. That don't seem right. Good. Hi, Heather. Mike's here.
See that? Hi. It's about the divorce papers?
No, I had a guy died in the back of my cab last night.
Sorry. Why are you still here?
I love the smell of ammonia. This tip was a John Doe. I'm looking into it.
Wouldn't that be a job for the police? Sorry.
No, you're right. Screw it.
Michael, it's good that you care.
I'm Mother Teresa's brother. Get to know me.
Yeah, I knew you. Once.
What are your plans for Thanksgiving?
I've been meaning to talk to you about
that. We should be together for Mike Jr.
Mikey and I are driving out to my parents. It's been over a year since we've been out there. I promised them.
It's okay. You say you know him, but how do I know that's true? What kind of cigarettes he smoke?
Lucky Strike.
Marlboro.
Oh, we got a winner.
Hey, malt liquor. What are you doing, stereotyping or something?
My apologies.
Apologies might be accepted.
I'm a little offended myself.
Yeah, you'll get over it. All right, not a man. I'm sorry. His name?
Webster.
Webster. His last or his first name?
Neither one. Hey, the man, he never gave his real name. I call him Webster because he knew every word in the damn dictionary and then some.
Webster ever tell you where he's from?
Or Webster wasn't no geyser when it came to information, you understand, especially personal information. Used to just toss back the old Sweeney. Philosophize.
Did you ever say why he drank?
He drank because he's happy. Yeah, we all happy down here, ain't we? Sitting down here watching the river flow. There was one thing, though. I don't know if it really matters to you.
Well, ask Kent.
Well, the other night when I was jonesing, Webster gives me a dollar.
Cheap bastard.
Hey, come on, Harry. The man gave me his last buck, all right? So I ask him why. He tells me it's to make up for all the things that he done in the past. That's all right.
What the hell are you doing?
Hey, Harry. The man did me a solid by giving up his last buck, all right? Decent man passes that sort of kindness along.
Thanks.
We have quite a few John Does. I'm sure none of them is your uncle. Most of them are loners. No one ever shows up for them. How old was your uncle?
15, maybe.
You don't know exactly?
Well, Helen, do you know the exact age of all your uncles?
Let's move on to personal effects. Maybe that'll narrow it down.
All right, let's see. He used to carry a small pocket Bible with him, if that's a help. He was a smoker.
Oh.
Oh, I know. We tell him to quit, but he loves his Marlboros. Loves his old Sweeney, too.
Sir, I am so sorry. I think we do have your uncle.
Thanksgiving's coming up, so I thought it'd be of some comfort to the family if we had a memento or two of his at the table.
Oh, but personal effects cannot be released until after the autopsy.
Oh, Helen, if I knew that, I never would have asked. Because I don't want you getting any trouble.
I'm so sorry for your loss. Maybe we can make an exception.
You'll release his effects?
Sure. Just call the authorities. You tell the young man everything you told me. His name's Officer Nelson. Seems really nice.
I'm gonna need this stuff back. Why you care about this bum anyway?
I inhaled his last breath.
I've seen you inhale a cheesesteak standing over a jumper. Now you're gonna get all weepy over a homeless drunk?
Yeah, I think he came out of the womb that way.
Where are you going for Thanksgiving?
Nowhere.
Oh. Well, I would have you over, but all the guys and our wives were going to the captain's, so.
Dirty cops not invited.
Phi Beta Kappa. He's a smart junkie, huh? Like William Burroughs.
Why junkie?
You said needle marks on the corpse? Hmm. Junkies crave sugar?
Yeah. So do diabetics.
Okay, call it a toss-up.
Needle marks in the wrong place for a junkie.
Your man highlighted a ton of verses in the Book of Job. You ever read the Book of Job?
Yeah, I had my Job lesson for today. Why don't you go catch some crackheads?
Well, God and the devil are in a pissing contest. See how far they can push Job before he curses God. All right. I will speak in the anguish of my spirit. I will complain in the bitterness of my soul. Well, who can blame him? He did no wrong. Add to that, God never apologizes to Job for all the changes he puts him through. He kills his livestock, his sons. He smites them with festering boils and worms, all on the bed, and never once says, oh, sorry, my bad. It's a mystery to me why people would want to worship a God who pulls this kind of crap. I guess we just all need to believe that somebody upstairs gives a damn.
We do?
Apparently you do.
I just care about the guy. You don't care about anybody?
We don't spend our time worrying about strangers. That's how we stay sane.
How big you want it bumped up?
Big as possible.
That's really faded. Resolution falls apart if we go bigger than 8x10. Monday okay?
Tomorrow?
Sorry, I'm closed. Tomorrow's Thanksgiving.
All right, can you do it tonight?
I got 40 jobs ahead of this one.
I'll pay you extra.
What's a big rush?
One of the boys in that picture might be a homeless man. He died. I need a good lead.
You figure a man dead or alive should be with his family at Thanksgiving.
Something like that.
Come by tomorrow morning. I'll have the photo ready.
What good's running out all these teachers?
There's a chance he taught music at a high school or college. He knew a lot about music. I figure he was a teacher.
We don't even know Webster's real name.
Well, if I come up with some other list, then we can cross-check.
Mom says he was a drunk.
Things happen to people.
Nobody can make people drink. So isn't it all their own fault?
Life's not that simple, Michael.
Maybe he drank because he got fired from his job.
Michael, what are you doing here?
Dad wanted to use my computer. I said it was okay.
Oh, the homeless man?
Yeah, the drunk.
Dad says he was really smart. Did crossword puzzles with a pen. That's why the bums called him Webster.
Webster? Really? Can I talk to you for a sec?
Maybe we should run on these with teachers in New Jersey, too.
Yeah, sure. Why not? I know I should have called you first.
No, it's okay. About Thanksgiving. Maybe you and Mikey would like to spend the morning together. Before we drive out to Mom and Dad's.
Oh. What is the time? 2-hour drive to Harrisburg.
No, Dad will be out hunting tomorrow anyway. Mom doesn't want us there till 7, so. How's the case coming?
The case? I'm not a cop, remember? How's that New Jersey teachers list coming, pal?
Heather.
Hey, Marcellus.
What brings you down to the Grease Palace? I thought you were nuts about nutrition. What's this?
Autopsy report from Mike's John Doe. Maybe he'll find something in it that will help him find out who the guy was.
And you're giving this to me to give to him?
Because I don't want him to get the wrong idea.
And what exactly is the idea?
I just filed divorce papers, Marcellus.
Hi, what can I get for you?
Just coffee, thanks.
Sure.
Maybe you're having second thoughts on this divorce thing. But you don't want him to know. He does a solid for Webster. Maybe you see him the guy you married way back when.
You know, I'm sure that there are people I would talk to about this sort of thing.
Hmm?
And I'm also sure that you're not one of them. Just don't say anything to Mike about this, okay?
Hey, I'm just the delivery boy. When did you start smoking again?
Tobacco helps you think. They did a study back in the 90s.
They who, Philip Morris?
What do you want, Marcellus?
Autopsy results. Just came in.
Thanks for volunteering.
I just wanted to see who was right. You were. Webster's a diabetic.
What'd he die of?
Everything. Heart, liver, lungs, you name it.
Coroner ballparks him at 45. My guy had to be at least 60.
When Charlie Parker died, the doctor at the scene tagged him at 53. He was 34. It's the needle and the damage done.
Webster didn't shoot drugs.
Well, alcohol and tobacco do a job.
Then why was there insulin still in his body?
I'm not following.
The guy treats himself like crap, but he still takes his daily dose.
Man couldn't make up his mind.
You sure know what he wanted at the end?
Well, he got lucky. A lot of cabs in this city. He got into yours.
This is your son.
Mike Jr. Mikey, this is Glenn.
Hi.
Hi.
Your father's doing a really nice thing. Where are you and your dad having Thanksgiving dinner?
Me and my mom are having dinner with my grandma and grandpa.
How much?
No, that's okay. Happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, you went to the trouble?
No, please. I'm happy to do it. I hope this helps. It looks to me like the two boys are at an old Eagles game.
Yeah. Franklin Field. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thanks, you too.
Come on. Oh, and he kept his feet inbound. Great catch, buddy.
Pass is right there.
Hey, but you got the good hands. Yeah, check out that arm.
Dad, Mom, aren't you going to do something with that envelope?
No, this is more fun. Mikey, just so you know, what's going on with your mom and me, it's got nothing to do with you. You know, sometimes people love each other, but then things happen.
Like you losing your job?
Oh, there were other things.
Like what?
Things.
Hey! Hey! Yeah, George Crawford. You told my guy this is an investigation?
Yeah, classified.
Yeah, maybe I can help. I'm a big mystery buff. Police procedurals. Yeah. Ed McBain?
Oh, yeah.
You ever read his 87th Precinct novels?
Yeah, McBain's stuff's great.
Yeah, yeah. I love the one where the killer leaves severed hands all over the city.
Yeah, George, I need to identify these two boys, where they're standing. I think it's Section 23.
I believe you're right.
Yeah, am I? It could be Section 25. Depends on whether they came up from 23 or down from 25.
See, now I wouldn't have thought of that.
You think these boys come for money?
Yeah, great seats, right in the 50-yard line.
Who gets the great seats?
Season ticket holders. You check the season ticket holders.
Now you're smoking.
Yeah, there'll be hundreds of names.
Well, we'll figure it out.
Yeah, Eagles haven't played here in over 30 years. Yeah, the records are at the corporate offices downtown now, and they're private. Yeah, no problem for you, though, huh?
No, my problem is time, George. I caught this triple homicide over in Gladwin.
Gruesome, huh?
Yeah, well, the case is Warren Hall's and old floor shams, I can tell you that. We know anybody at the Eagles office?
Well, Shorty's still working tickets, but,
Ed McBain once told me that everything boils down to connections.
You know Ed McBain?
Why? You want me to get you an autograph?
How'd you do with your lists?
Nothing.
Let's lose these cancer sticks.
Karen, check, please.
Be right there.
What's your problem?
What's my problem? My problem is, unlike Joe, I brought up crap in my life for myself. Mistakes were all mine.
Maybe that's what Bollinger was trying to tell you.
Who's Bollinger?
Paul Bollinger. That's your guy. The Bollinger's name is on the season ticket holders list and on my list. My list? Customers who bought insulin within a 5-mile radius of the riverbanks. You could not get this list. But me, still being a cop, and there being no client pharmacist privilege, I could get this list, which you could not get. Thanksgiving. Once a year, I'm magnanimous.
Thank you.
I'll inform the family.
No. No, this is mine.
Police matters mine. Always has been.
I started this, I'll finish.
It's over. Mission accomplished.
Marcellus, I gotta find out.
What?
You're suffering, but do you know why? Don't make my mistake.
What his mistake was? Where his life went wrong?
You dig into this guy's past for the rest of your life, you're never gonna figure that out. Nobody ever knows what goes on in other people's heads. I'll handle it from here.
Keep me in the loop.
Thank you.
beautiful day for Thanksgiving. You're not working all day, I hope.
Yep, I am.
Are they making you?
No, it's not like that.
Well, what about your family?
Leave the man alone, dear.
But no one on Thanksgiving.
Up here on the right. Here you go, young man. Give me back,
Keep it.
No, it's way too much.
We insist.
No, really, look, I don't...
And buy yourself dinner at a nice restaurant. Unbilling me.
Yeah, dinner. With all the trimmings.
Here they are! Oh, I'm so glad to see you. Look at you! Look at you!
Hear about another uncle?
No, same guy. I need a little help.
First time, shame on you. Second time, shame on me.
Oh, look, I'm sorry that I wasn't straight with you. But believe me, I was just trying to get the guy home. I was there when he died, and that's what he wanted.
Well, apparently his real family didn't share that wish.
Excuse me?
His brother Peter didn't want the body. He asked us to cremate him. That's what we did.
Yeah. The ashes?
When you feel you're all in and you've decided you can't win, tell yourself it won't be for long. You're between dark and dawn. You've got too much time, you can't kill. Your wheels are spinning, but you're standing still. It's all flat and forlorn in between dark and dawn.
I'm worried about him, Grizz. His cell phone's not answering. It's not like him to turn it off.
Yeah, I'm sure he's all right.
Marcellus called me, said that he looked really down, and I wanted to call him to wish him a happy Thanksgiving.
Heather, don't worry. I'll try to track him down.
You hear from him, you call me, okay?
You be at your parents?
Nope. I'm not going anywhere until I know he's okay.
Between
dark
and
dawn.
That's where nothing's always going on. Between dark and dawn. Wait till the sun comes out. You're gonna wonder what the fuss was all about. You've been standing in the rain, but pretty soon you're gonna be on your way again. Between dark and dawn. You're between dark and dawn. Between dark and dawn. You're between dark and dawn.
Yes?
Peter Ballinger?
Yes?
I'm Michael Oshansky. This is your brother. He died in the back of my cab.
Come in. Come in.
This was home for him?
Yes. This is where we grew up.
And you just let him burn? No funeral? No prayers?
Peter, who is it?
Nobody. I'll just be a minute.
How long did you know him?
He was your brother.
Yeah. And how long did you know him? 20 minutes?
Does that mean nothing to you? He was a sharp guy.
He was a selfish son of a bitch. He had smarts, he had looks, money from Dad, he threw it all away.
Must have been a reason.
Paul was the reason. Although you could never get him to admit it. He blamed everything on his getting fired. He used to teach philosophy up at Yale a long time ago.
And after he was fired?
Hardly ever saw him. Never came around. Wanted to be left alone. And that's what we did, finally. But it wasn't until after he hurt me and he hurt my family.
What'd he do?
He stole money, he stole jewels, he even stole some of my first editions. He'd do anything, he'd steal anything so he could get money, so he could go out and get drunk.
He had regrets.
Paul? Paul admitted that he was wrong about something?
He said that he had made mistakes.
Yeah. Well, I wish he'd said that to me.
Who's who? Here.
This, facing the camera, is Paul. Scratched out his face and left mine. A photo of me.
Looks that way.
I didn't know.
Well, how would you?
I love my brother, Mr. Olshansky. In the way that they say only twins can love. I cried for him. I cried for him many, many times. But I had to stop. I finally had to stop before it killed me.
The other night when he died, he wanted me to take him here to see you. We just didn't make it in time.
Did he say why?
No. But I think that he wanted to say he was sorry.
Hello? Yes, he is. Okay, it's for you. It's Marcellus.
How'd you find me?
I was your partner. I know what you're gonna do before you do. Your wife's worried sick about you, man. Call her. She's still at home.
Fine. Everything's okay.
Did you find what you were looking for?
Yeah, that's Webster's brother.
Yeah, but did you find what you were looking for?
I'm sorry. I know that doesn't make everything okay, but I am sorry. To both of you.
And none of us is free of suffering. Paul Ballinger suffered. Yet in the midst of that, he touched the heart of my friend, Mike Olshansky. In turn, Mike's caring for Paul has touched the hearts of others. And so it is, the circle goes around,
And God's greatest gift of all, love, abides. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you this day for once again reminding us that we are all part of the human family and that it is our duty to look after one another. We ask you to open the gates to paradise to your servant, Paul Ballinger, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith and love. Amen.
What I'm looking for after all this time keeps me moving forward, trying to find it. Since I learned to walk, all I've done is run. Ready on my mark, doesn't everyone need a place in the world?
All right. Thank you, Father.
Could you write me for?
I owe you one, Chris.
No, you don't.
Beyond the door, it's open.
Okay.
Well, I'm sad, but I'm not angry anymore. Feels a whole lot better. I have you to thank for that.
Well.
Thanks.
For your place in the world.
What's this I hear about free eats?
Follow him.
Take some of us a little longer. A few false starts gonna make you strong. When I'm sure I finally found it, gonna wrap these arms all around it. Could be one more mile, or just one step back in a lover's smile down a darkened path. Your friends will take our side, enemies will curse us. But to be alive is to know your purpose. It's your place in the world. Place in the world. Your place in the world.
Come on.